This week we're going to talk about baptism, and there's a lot of confusion, a lot of common questions, so we're going to cover that. And there's two types of baptisms in the Bible that really stand out. In Matthew chapter 3, verses 11 to 15, you see both of them back to back. John the Baptist said that Jesus is going to come and baptize you with the Holy Spirit in fire. And then Jesus was baptized in water. So the two baptisms, baptism in water, but then also the baptism of the Holy Spirit. So this week we're going to focus on water baptism, but first the baptism of the Holy Spirit. Now, some people think that baptism of the Holy Spirit refers to when you put your trust in Jesus, you have the Holy Spirit in you for the first time, dwelling in you forever. And that's what some people think of with that term. But then also with that term, there's a filling. There's a command in Scripture, be filled with the Holy Spirit. So that filling, because we leak, because we sin and we rebel, we need to be filled. And how much more will the Father give the Holy Spirit to those who ask? So that repetitive filling, where we're asking, confessing our sins and yielding. And then there's also another viewpoint that the baptism of the Holy Spirit refers to a second blessing. And this is evidenced by speaking in tongues. Well, what I would say about that is that speaking in tongues is in the Bible. There's nowhere in the Bible that says that gift is going to stop. But as it's in the Bible, some people have that gift and then some don't have that gift. And so what that passage does not teach is that you have to speak in tongues to be saved. And if you don't speak in tongues, you don't have the Holy Spirit. Those are false notions. Those are lies and myths. So whether the baptism of the Holy Spirit is first time you receive the Holy Spirit forever dwelling in you, that repetitive filling, or a special touch and blessing, different Christians have different views of what that phrase means, but it's very clear in Scripture. With water baptism and baptism of the Holy Spirit, both mean immersion, and both are very good, and both are a blessing. So be immersed in water baptism, and let the Holy Spirit immerse you.